Pencil. Is an area of small towns. Sacramento and Joaquin.
And make sure that you put your name this time on it. Maybe on the bottom or something, but you need to put your name on there. Because we're not going to do that again, alright?
Do what?
Do another one like that. Well, you know how you did that other one? And she didn't find you?
The teacher did find it, and my name was on it.
Oh.
Her desk was messy, but then someone cleaned it up, and then they found it.
So you gave it to her?
No, she found it.
Oh, she found it? So
because I was helping her at recess, and then she said, oh.
So what did she did she say, I'm sorry?
Yeah. Many royal communities. There. Okay. All the information for that one. Yeah. I'm gonna cut my nails. Okay. And last but not least, suburban area. A suburban then urban area. There's tears. Two N area. Area. And just outside. City. Not every everyone in. Not everyone in California. California lives in or around cities. draw the next building blue. So it can look beautiful. So then when the teacher sees, she'll be like, oh my gosh, it's so beautiful. I want this to be the beautiful project she'll ever see her entire life. Well, in the year. Let's see. Let's see here. I like these songs. Makes it nice and quiet. Now I just have to do two more. Let's open some light. Thank you. Now one more. Suburban, a lot of houses. Bored, and I don't have anything else to do, and I could just read, because nothing is better without reading. My book's in here. Here. I should do a video of reading, but some of these words are very hard. It's going on the YouTube, and they could see it forever and ever. Well, it's okay. They'll just know that I didn't know the word, so I just do it. Hey guys, it's me, Jacqueline. And today, we are going to be reading Ruby's Wish. So, yes. And the book is by Sharon Ying Bridges. And it's illustrated by Sophie Blackall. That's my friend's name, Sophie. So, yes. And this is my class. Yeah. This is this is like my points. I'm trying to cover the name, but you guys still can't read it either way. Okay. It says, if you walk down a certain road in a certain city in China, past the pet market with its yellow and green rice birds hopping in their bamboo cages. In their porcelain bowls, you will come to a block of houses, five houses wide and seven houses deep. Many families live here now, and the buildings are brown with age and dirt. But if you look closely, you'll see that once upon a time, this was all one house, the magnificent home of one family. And here's the page. So yeah, that's the page. The house was built by an old man who returned from the Gold Mountain. That was what the Chinese called California. When many men left to join the gold rush there, and few came back again. But as I said, this man did come back. He came back very rich, and he did what rich men did in old China. He married many wives. His wives had many sons, and these sons also had many wives. So at one time, the house was filled with sheikhs and lauder of over 100 children. And here is the picture. And this is the rich man that came back from the gold rush. And at the end, I'm going to ask you a few questions about the book, and then you have to leave it in the comments down below. Amongst these children was a little girl that everyone called Ruby, because she loved the color red. In China, red is the color of celebration. On New Year's Day, children received red envelopes full of lucky, good luck money. Brides wear red on their weddings, but Ruby instead on wearing red every day. Even when her mother made her wear some other colors, like all her other cousins, Ruby would tie up her jet black hair with red ribbons. And here is the picture. And this is the ribbon in her hair. Because he had so many grandchildren, Ruby's grandfather hired a teacher to come to the house. Any grandchild who wanted to learn could join the classes. This was unusual in China in those days. When most girls were This was unusual in China those days, when most girls were never taught to read or write. Whenever the weather was fine, classes were held in the garden. The windows of Ruby's grandfather's office opened into that garden. Often he would rise from his desk to gaze out of his windows at the grandchildren. One day, Ruby's grandfather looked down from his window to see the high white wall of the garden parsed with kalji. His grandchildren had been practicing their handwriting. Ruby's grandfather left to see that many had smudged ink on their hands and faces. Then he noticed a sheet that was more beautiful than the rest. Which of his grandchildren had produced such wonderful calligraphy? Down in the garden, the teacher was praising Ruby. Her ears were turning as bright red as her jacket. Ruby was doing as well as her boy cousins in her studies. She had to work much harder. When the boys had finished their studies for the day, they were free to play. But the girls had to learn about cooking and keeping house. In fact, as far as their mothers were concerned, these were the only things girls had to learn. One by one, the girls stopped going to classes, all except Ruby. She would catch up on her embroidery at night. Many nights, her candle flickered long after everyone else had gone to bed. One day, the children were asked to write a poem. Ruby wrote, "Bad luck to be born a girl. Worst luck to be born into this house where only boys are cared for." Ruby's teacher was very impressed by the poem. He showed it to Ruby's grandfather. Ruby's grandfather was also impressed, but he was worried about what the poem said. He summoned Ruby into his office. Ruby found her grandfather sitting in his chair. Her poem spread open on his desk. "Did you write this poem?" asked Ruby's grandfather. "Yes, I did, grandfather," answered Ruby. "Do you really think that in this house we only care for boys?" "Oh, no, grandfather," said Ruby, very sorry that she had upset him. "You take good care of all of us, and for that we are all grateful." Little Ruby, her grandfather said gently, "I really would like to know why you wrote this poem. How are the boys better looked after?"
Well, said Ruby, trying to think of a small, important thing. When it is the moon festival, and we are each given half a moon cake, the boys always get the half with yellow moon yolk. Said her grandfather, as he was still waiting. Is that so? Yes, continued Ruby. And when it is the lantern festival, the girls are given simple paper lanterns, but the boys have red lanterns in the shapes of goldfish, pores, and dragons. Ruby's grandfather chuckled. He'd never thought about it before. He could imagine how Ruby would have liked a red lantern. Oh, I keep forgetting to show you the picture. And you could pause the video if you want to see the pictures more longer. But most importantly, said Ruby, staring hard at her red shoes, the boys will get to go to university, but the girls will be married. Don't you want to be married? Asked her grandfather. You know you are very lucky. A daughter of this house and marry, and this house can marry any man. I know, Grandfather, said Ruby, but I'd much rather go to university. Ruby's grandfather touched her hair. Thank you for talking to me, Ruby, he said. Go on with your lessons. Make the most of them while you can. So Ruby went on with her lessons. Some of the boys grew up and went away to university. Some stayed in the house and started families of their own. But when they grew up, all the girls were married and sent away to live in their husbands' homes. Ruby knew it would soon be her turn. In the ponds, Ruby could see the orange and white carp gulping for breath under a thin layer of glass of ice. It would soon be Chinese New Year. Ruby felt sure it would be her last one at home. On New Year's Day, Ruby put on her red velvet shoes and tied red ribbons in her hair. Then she went to wish everyone a happy New Year. She started with her married cousins, then worked her way up through her parents, aunts, and uncles. Each one gave her a red packet full of lucky money. Finally, she bowed before her grandfather. Good luck and proceedly, grandfather, she said. Good luck, little Ruby, replied her grandfather, and he handed her a very fat red packet. Ruby could feel the eyes of all her family on her as she opened the lucky red envelope. Can you guess what was in it? It wasn't money. It was something much better than that. was a letter from a university saying that they would be proud to accept Ruby as one of their very first female students. So that's how Ruby got her wish. It's a true story. And how do I know this? Well, Ruby is my grandmother. And every day, she still wears a little red. And this is the grandmother. And the end. So I hope you guys liked the story. Don't forget to subscribe. While you're at it, turn on post notifications, like the video, all that. Bye. That was a long one. Now I can put this book away. Now I just have to clean my room. I gotta clean up now. I got a great idea. After I clean my room. Let me just try it out. Oh, dang, man. Okay, bye. I just look crayon.
I'm sorry that it took so long to do this video. I forgot that I needed it to record it. To record on Saturday. So that's why I'm doing it now. That's why it's already 50 minutes. I'm sorry to waste your time watching this whole video. But if you stay till the end, you are a legit legend. Sitting here for 50 minutes watching me just clean my room, do my homework, and do all this kind of stuff. And I want to thank you so much, all you guys, that you are spending your time watching me. And yes, I am going to try to do it every day, but like I won't do it like at 12. I won't do it till 7 a.m. to 2. And I don't think I can do it on Tuesdays. I'll just see what I have on my schedule. And if I don't upload, you know why. It's because I'm busy. Or if I do my homework really late and I can't even do my homework. I mean, can't even record. You'll know why I didn't upload. So, yes, I will try to. I'm so sorry that I almost forgot about you guys. Because I forgot I had to do my homework, and then I did my homework. And then, yeah. And now it's 51 for me talking. Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to finish cleaning my room after this video because I really need to not pay attention to the camera. Just put the camera away, edit this video. I don't even edit this video. I just press play, and then when I'm done, just press, like, it's like a little square box. And this is how I pause it. It's like this, like, pause button that was, like, white, and then it's, like, black. So then I press that, and then, yeah. Now when I'm done, I press it again, and then it shows me it. So, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna stop. So, yeah. 52 minutes just for me talking. Like, 2 minutes extra. Okay, bye! Shoutouts to OPS Awesome Possum Productions, by the way.